Hi, AT from CNC at home. I want to go through the full process of creating in LightBurn a couple coasters and then doing the burn on the laser, painting on the titanium dioxide. I'm going to use the titanium dioxide method for this, and just kind of talk through all the steps that you really have to do. And it's going to start here in the CAD. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. What I'm going to be doing is making a set of two coasters for a more of a panoramic image. I do some gaming with some friends and I wanted to do something, and the picture that I really like is wide. So I was like, okay, two coasters is it. That's what I'm going to do. So the first thing I'm going to do is bring my image in. And we'll place it down in the lower left corner. And I do have my LC50 selected, so that's the laser that I'm going to use. The image size is a little bit big, and I know that the burning area of a coaster or a tile is approximately 108 millimeters. When I put two of them together, there's a little bit of a gap between them, so that adds a little bit of distance. So I'm going to treat each coaster as if it were 109 millimeters. And I'm going to set the width then to 109 times 2. One of the features that you can do within LightBurn is doing math while you're entering your numbers. We see that the height is greater than the 108 or 109, which is fine. We'll lose a little bit off the bottom and a little bit off the top. And I'm talking just a little bit, just a few millimeters. It should look good. If we really wanted to see what that looks or is going to look like, we can put a rectangle on here. So let's do this. Let's go to one of our tool layers, create a rectangle. We'll come in, turn off our aspect ratio lock, and we want the width to be 109 times 2 and the height to be 109. We'll relock that. And then we'll take our rectangle and just put it down in the lower corner. And then we can see what we're going to be missing from our image. Let's zoom in so we can see that better. Okay, so we are going to lose it all off the top, but nothing off the bottom. One thing that I can do is I can use this tool layer as a mask. So I can select our image, and then holding the shift key, I can select that tool layer, and then by right clicking I can say apply mask. Now our construction box has cropped our image, essentially just the top part. What I can do is I can select just the image, and by pressing the control key and then the down arrow, I can move it down basically a millimeter at a time to see what looks best, because I'd like to get the top of this ship in there. So this looks pretty good. That's what I'm going to do. The other thing I want to do is I want to change the contrast of this image. It's very, very dark, and I'm afraid that's going to turn out just too dark on the coaster. So I go into my shape properties, and I'm going to change its brightness. Let's start with that. Change it to 20. See how that looks. Not bad. What does it look like at 25? Starting to look a little washed out, and that tends to be okay for coasters. Let's do a quick preview and see what that looks like. The preview is still showing it awfully dark, so that's not going to really help us know whether it's going to turn out or not. I'm going to paint up four tiles. That way I can do a set, and if I don't like the way it turned out, I can tweak the parameters a little bit and burn it again. Let's start with this 25% brightness, and we'll make sure that our layer is set to the correct parameters. It looks right, but let's go into the library, turn on tile, titanium dioxide, and we have image. Let's go ahead and assign that to our layer. And it does look like it was set to that already. This should be all ready to go. It's just a matter of getting the tiles painted up and put them in the laser. Let's go over to the paintbrush, see how that does. And once we have the tiles painted up, we'll move them over to the laser. I'll show you how I get the laser aligned with the tiles, or actually the tiles aligned with the laser. And I'm going to use relative coordinates instead of absolute. So let's go under here and say current position. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put the laser down here in this corner of the tiles and say, that's my zero spot. And by telling it current position and lower left, which I have selected here, that's how this is going to play out. Here we have four basic tiles and our titanium dioxide mixture with denatured alcohol. Just mixing it up a little bit there. Going to put some on a brush and paint it on. Look how white this is when it gets painted on. These are white tiles. Look how much whiter the titanium dioxide is. You can see some streaking, and so I didn't have enough mixture on there, so just recover these areas. I found that my mixture is actually a bit on the thick side. I need to thin this out a little bit. Once you have a good coating, you're ready to go over to the laser. I start by homing the laser in the lower left-hand corner. And then I'm going to move the gantry up out of the way so I can very carefully put these tiles in place. Titanium dioxide, once it's on the tile, is not stuck to the tile. It's just sitting on there. Any little brush with your finger or bumping it with anything else will knock it off. So I'm being very careful to hold from underneath the tiles, set them down, touching from the sides, getting them lined up with each other. Once I have the tiles aligned with each other, I'm going to use the gantry beam itself to be my straight edge. I'm going to get it to a position where I can look down at the top of my tiles, make sure that they're aligned or squared with the gantry beam itself. Then I know that I'm at least squared with the laser. Because I moved the gantry beam, I did rehome it here. Now I'm going to set my burn start location. I am going to use a local coordinate, so basically, or current location is going to be my zero point. I'm going to turn on the laser at 0.2% and then move it to the lower left-hand corner of the tile. When I get close to where I want it, I go into incremental mode where I'm moving half a millimeter at a time. One thing that I had forgotten to do initially was to get the laser focused for the height of a tile. So I grabbed another tile that I had because I don't want to put the focusing block on that titanium dioxide because it'll scrape it off super quickly. Then I realized I really want to focus at the same Y positioning as my tiles. My honeycomb is not exactly flat, so this helps me be a little more accurate. I brought the laser back to my origin that I have for my burning. I put the focusing block on the far side, can't see it. That's where the focusing block is, and then I adjusted the laser down to that focusing block to make sure that the laser is focused to the top of the tiles. Now that that's done, I can just remove my extra tile out of the way. Now that we have the tiles in position, let's do a quick frame to make sure everything is going to be on the tiles when we burn it. Let's take a look. Okay, doing the frame showed us that we were on the left-hand side. We're actually on the material. So I'm going to bump that over a half a millimeter, and then we'll do the frame again. Right side looks good, top looks good, bottom looks good, and the left side, we're still on it just a little bit. So let's move over another half millimeter. Check it again.
Probably wouldn't hurt to come down a half milliliter as well. Okay,
that's looking much better. So we'll just come down a half millimeter. We'll call it good. I'm going to get the exhaust turned on, and then we'll start the burn. Here's where we left off. The burn turned out okay, but it's still really dark. So let's select the image and lighten it up. One thing that I remembered about last night is I lightened this up and it really starts to get, contrasty, very black and white, so it doesn't look so great. And then I remembered that I can go negative with these numbers. So what I want to do is try taking the contrast down. I'm going to go negative 25, so it flattens it. Everything's much more gray, less black and white. If we do a preview on that. Okay, looking a little better. Let's go even further. Let's try negative 50. In the image on the screen, it looks really flat. When we do the preview, let's make this a little larger. It looks like it's coming out pretty well. What I want to do is give this a try and see how it works. It's still going to be pretty dark. I'm afraid if I go any further, we can try it. Just try negative 70. See how that looks. Yeah, that's just too flat. So we'll put that back at negative 50. Cross our fingers and hope that it works. I have the next set of tiles in the laser, so I'm going to go ahead and get those zeroed up and we'll do the burn. We'll use the same parameters, so we'll use the 4,000 millimeters per minute at 75% power. So let's get the laser homed and then we'll move it into position. Just move it up. Move it over. We'll start the laser. Let's get the laser protector out of the way here for a second so we can see the laser beam. So we'll turn that on. That also turns on the air assist. You can hear that come on. Okay, so right on the edge there. Okay, we'll go into smaller movements. Okay, that's on. Okay, that's just off. We'll go one more and then we'll go over a couple. This should be in a good position. Let's do a frame, make sure we're not touching the laser, or the laser's not touching the tiles as we go around. We want our image to be just slightly bigger than the tiles. Okay, that looks good. Let's go ahead and start the burn. This is going to take over an hour. According to the preview, it's going to take an hour and 17. Let's hope it turns out well. Let's go ahead and get that started. And we'll get the exhaust fan going as well. First look, it certainly turned out lighter. We'll see what it looks like once we get the titanium dioxide cleaned off of here. Now, here's something that's happened on these coasters a little bit. If you look here, the titanium dioxide scrubbed right off, and
part of that, I'm hoping, is because I did not clean these tiles before I started the project. I had forgotten that step, and it's something that's important to make sure that the tile's clean, because if there's any oils or greases or anything, this kind of thing can happen. So I'm hoping that's what the issue is. It's not coming off anywhere else. It's on here pretty solid. Otherwise, all right, there we go. Once these get dried up, we can put them next to the first set and see how they compare. They both have their pluses and minuses, I guess. This part of the image is just really bad. I may just go with that then as a coaster, which is kind of where the action is. We'll see. Let's get them dried up. Well, there we have it side by side. It'll be interesting to see how this turns out on the video. This lower one is definitely darker. This one is definitely lighter. Looking at the screen on the video camera, this one doesn't look too bad. This one looks a little dark. In person, however, this one doesn't look too bad. Actually, they need to look too bad, but this one does look a little bit light. This one looks a little bit dark. I suppose I could do one kind of in between. The issue really is it's a dark image, and that doesn't work well with this process. It'll be interesting to see what the other people think about this. It's a fun experiment to do. I was kind of questioning this image to begin with just because it was so dark. And that kind of showed me that it was dark and there's not a whole lot of saving it. We can get something from it, something usable. The other thing that I took away is I have to clean my tiles. I have a spot over here too where it did the same thing. I really need to clean these tiles before I put the stuff on there, and I've done that in the past. I just kind of, in my mind, is like, oh, I'll do that when I get these downstairs and ready, starting to prep them. I'll get them ready. Totally forgot. I did a couple more coasters in the theme of Ghosts of Salt Marsh. I just grabbed a couple images off the internet and tried to adjust my contrast and my brightness so that they would turn out well. This one is a little bit light, but actually not too bad. This one over here I thought turned out relatively good, given both of these relatively dark initial images. With enough adjustment and a few tests here and there, doing images using the titanium dioxide works really well. The image is permanently there, and you can give these coasters or keep the coasters, do whatever you want with them, have your own customized coasters. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a thumbs up. If you like the content of the channel, think about subscribing. It really helps us out. Enjoy doing your CNC at home projects.